Hey there, everybody. How y'all doing? Thank you for coming back as always. I appreciate it. Really hope you're having a wonderful day or night. And welcome back to my channel. As always, I'm Deluxe. All right, let's do another Transformer review. Yeah. Today I'll be taking a look at the Studio Series 86 movie line, Wreck-Gar. Finally got this guy in. There he is. Beautiful artwork. I love that. Love how the eyes are glowing. That shows right here. Looks really good. And another side. And then you got the back. He transforms in 22 steps. He transforms to his motorcycle. Looks good. Love the box. Very excited to get this guy. So let's just get right to it. That's what you came for. Yeah. All right, folks. As always, let's take a look what he comes with. Now, like all Studio Series, they come with a little background scene. And in this one, you get the Planet Junk, which looks really good. I like it. I love the artwork. Got the ship in the background. Now, you can display kind of... You can get there. Yep, the spikes are, you know, all push out a little bit, but kind of looks good right there. I like that. So you can do that. If you have room to display it like that, that will be awesome. He comes with his the two tires, which will be, you know, shields or something like that. You can use it. He comes with his little axe. It looks good. It does a spin-a-rooney. Very, very nicely done. No paint. A little small. Kind of wish it was a little longer. Yeah, but it's fine. But it will store back here like this. And if you want to, I mean, it doesn't look right, but it can store up here too. There's a little slot right up here, and you can store it right there if you want to. That's an option. I would never do that, but you may like it like that. But I really like it right there. That's pretty cool. Someone store, you can move it around however you want to. And you can store it like that. Like I said, the tires, I'll show you that a little more better detail when bot mode. But that is all he comes with. All right, let's talk about the man of the hour. This is Wreck-Gar in his bike mode, as you just saw. And I think it looks really freaking good. I like it. Very nice. He does have little two kickstands, which is awesome. Right here, they do flip out. So if you don't want to, you know, if you want to have them rolling... Now, it does, on this surface, it probably won't do that. It won't roll that well, but he does roll pretty good. But this is a smooth surface, so, but they do move. So, kind of gets caught up a little bit on back here. You may have to adjust a little bit, but it will spin. So, they will roll. That's nice. Very nicely done. You got this. This is paint right here, kind of a tannish paint right there. The red is painted on the spikes. Then you got the rims. Kind of, they're supposed to kind of match, I guess, this gold up here, which looks really good, the flames. But it comes off as kind of a mustard kind of yellow. But it kind of is supposed to be, I think, supposed to match up with that. Then you got some gold paint right here. Looks like I got a little scratch on mine. Golly. But you got some gold paint right there. You got the red right there. You got the, it's cold outside nipples right here. They aren't all ball, they're on ball pay, or ball joints. They can move around. I'll show you that more in, bot mode. And now she got some nice red stripe right here. Looks good. And you got some kind of a what color is that? Kind of a tannish brown, light brown right there. That's paint. That's paint right there. The motor is painted silver. Once again, you got the gold for the flames. Even the speedometer is painted. Nicely done with silver. Then you got the saddle bags. They do move up and down. Then you got these spikes. Now they are little. They do have a little give to them, not much. Now this one comes out. I don't know if they're supposed to come off, but this one comes off. The other three do not. They're really pegged in there real good. I don't know if they're supposed to come off, but mine does a little bit. But they do got a little give. Don't do it too hard. You will probably break them, but they got a little give to them. You got the back, nicely done. You can tell robot pieces everywhere. You got the legs, nice paint right there. And you got the hands right there. They could have done a little cover right there, a little open up cover to cover that, but they didn't. They should have done that. Like I said, you do have the nice kickstands, which you have to have fingernails to pull them out. But other than that, looks really good. I like the bike mode. And it can stand up like that. Looks really nice. So there you go. That is Wreck-Gar in his motorcycle mode. And real quick, there he is next to a Deluxe Siege Red Alert. He is Voyager scale, if I didn't mention that. Yeah, he's pretty big.
A lot bigger, so he's not scaling that well with the Deluxes, but he's a big boy. So there you go. Scale. And Crapagonics, crappie toilet paper, some bottled aspirin, and Care Bears for more scale. All right, transformation time. Oh, I forgot to mention, you can see his head right there on top of that's paint right there. But all right, first things first, we'll do the legs. You're going to flip in these right here. Now what you want to do is you're going to unpeg the foot right here. Plugs in right there. You're just going to bring out this the tire, and I'll show you the tire once again. There you go. It's got that mustard kind of yellow, then the red spikes. Looks good. All right, unpeg it from that one as well. Move these down. You're going to put the feet up, and that's basically how you transform the legs. So you want to do that. All right, so you want to come up here. Want to unpeg. Now these are pegged right here. Right here. Be careful. That is a small little peg, so don't, you know, try to rip it out or anything like that. You may break that peg, so just be careful. You want to bring it down a little bit. Take off the tire. You got the two tires. Okay. So then you want to come open up the arms like that. And then move the face down like here, like that. All right, then you want to take this piece right here. You got this nice translucent, kind of got a blue tint to it. Want to collapse it in like that. Move it in like there. Then you move the handlebars. I forgot to mention the handlebars, they are soft plastic. The brakes, you can move a little flexible, so that's good. Sorry I didn't mention that in the that mode. All right, so then you want to kind of collapse everything like this. Kind of combine awards it all. And basically what you want to do is try to get like this. So you want to collapse it. See this little peg right here? It's going to go into that tab right there. So you can do it like that. Now, these, the arms, there's a peg right here. They're going to go into this tab right in here. Okay. So make sure you got to line it up a little bit and then just collapse it in. You know how I am with lining up stuff. Golly. Move the arms down. Okay. Let me try to, there we go. Did they tab in? There we go, tabbed in right there. Okay, reveal the head. All right, then all you gotta do is flip out the hands, maneuver this around like that, flip out the hands again, move it like there, and there you go. That is basically how you transform him. So let me clean him up a little bit, and I will come right back. All right, back from cleaning up a little bit, and there you go. There he is holding his weapon. He can hold it in either hand if it's good. He's still spin-a-rooney. All right, now with the tires, you can put them in wherever you want. You got four choices. So what you're basically going to do is you're going to go over this like that. You put one right there. You can put it on that side too. Then you can put one on here, or you can put both of them on the legs. It doesn't matter whichever you how you want to display your Wreck-Gar, but that is how you do it. That's pretty cool. I like it. Now, when you put them on the legs, it does kind of get in the way of, like, the, you know, spreading out, which I'll show you articulation a little bit. So just keep in mind that. So, but I'm going to take these off real quick so we can look at him and look at his articulation. I think that's it. Okay. Now, you can store this in the back here. I'm sure that's what it meant to, instead of doing it in, you know, in the bot mode, or I mean alt mode, you can display it. You can put it back here. You just tap it right here, and you can hold it back there. So I'm sure that's what they meant for it. Instead of doing it in bot or alt mode, you can carry it back there. So options are always great with Transformers. All right, so let's take a quick look at him. Looks good. I love that freaking head sculpt. Look at those eyes. That cherry red looks so good. Man, the mustache is flexible. It's got nice soft paint or a plastic. The goatee, It can move too a little bit, but not as much as the mustache. But that is a beautiful head sculpt. Nice gold paint right here. And right here on the side, this kind of a light blue right there. You got the turbine nipples right here. Like I said, they're on a ball joint, so you can move them around. Man, it's cold outside. You got this down here. You got the little side skirts or little saddle bags. And then this is painted right here. Looks good. Paint right there. And on here, you got the paint right here. And the red looks good. And the back cleans up really good. And the back right there. A little gappage right there. And he does have some waffles. So I'm sure somebody's going to fill in those gaps. Third party or something. All right. Once again, beautiful. Beautiful head sculpt. Love that. Look down a little bit. Look up a little bit as well. If you turn it away, you can look up quite a bit. Side to side. And no attitude. But I love that head sculpt. Looks good. All right. Arms. Love how they can go up to there. I love this right here. Fills in that. You know, not an empty space or anything. Looks good. Now, if you want to, you can untap. You can pull the chest out a little bit. And it will give him a back butterfly. If you want to take some dynamic poses, you have that option, but they're supposed to be tabbed in like that. So you can go all the way around. You do have 90 degrees for the elbow bend, bicep swivel, up and down because the hand, but like I said, I wish they would fill this gap in. I'm sure somebody's going to do that. You do have a swivel with the hand as well. All right. Waist swivel. Good. You do have an ab crunch. Now mine does not stay in that well. So you can just flip it back and forth. I'm sure you can put some fingernail polish, some clear fingernail polish or something to make that a little tighter. Because when you're just, you know, moving it, it will start moving up like that. So that's about the, you know, about the only tolerance issue I have right there is that. But hey, at least he has a ab crunch. That is awesome. All right. Flip these up. Soft ratchets, which sound really good. Nice Van Damme all day long. And kick up, kick back, thigh swivel right there. Knee about 90 degrees for the knee bend. And you do got like a kick up like that just because of transformation, but that's just a weird thing. Toe tilt up, down, and I love the rocker. I love how the rocker looks like that. It looks pretty cool. Very nice. But I do love how they did that. They filled in the underarm. That is nice. So that's good. And the handlebars can move up and down if you want to, but they're supposed to be down. But there you go. That's the back. If you want to put the weapon right there too, you have that option. So there you go. He looks good. Really good. But that is Wreck-Gar with the articulation and sculpt work. All right. So there he is next to Ultra Magnus and Springer. You got Ironhide, Hound, and Optimus Prime. Fortunately, I put up all of my other Studio Series stuff, so I don't have any like Hot Rod or RC or anything to, or Cup or anything. I don't have them out right now, but there you go. There's a little difference in a scale right there for you. And Crapagonics, Crappie Toilet Paper, Aspirin, Care Bears, and Squeaks for more scale. All right, let's talk about some Studio Series Wreck-Gar. Once again, Studio Series put out a great, great product. They are really knocking it out of the park. Dinobots, man, give me all the Dinobots. Give me Perceptor. Give me Blaster. Come on now. But yeah, Wreck-Gar, really, really fun. Only issues I have, and they're nitpick, really, to be honest. The weapon, I wish it was a little longer. You know, that's just a little thing. My ab crunch does not really stick in, so you just barely move it, you know, it will start moving out. So That's just a little tolerance issue. You can probably fix that. If I put some like fingernail polish or something, it may tighten that up a little bit and maybe grab onto it. Or maybe some super glue, you know, work it in a little bit. But other than that, I really don't have any other issues. The spikes, you know, like I said, one of them, mine comes off. I don't know for sure if it's supposed to come off, but it would kind of be cool if you could take them off or if they maybe retracted or something, because they do get kind of in the way. They will start poking you. It's not sharp or anything like that, but they do get in the way a little bit sometimes. But, and you got the turbo nipples are awesome. So yeah, overall, this is a great release. I can't wait. I'm going to get another one, and I can't wait for them to make some of the Junkions. That one, I know they're making one. I would love to have them make like three or four of them. That'd be pretty cool. Have your little display with that. But yeah, love it. Love it. Love it. I like the alt mode. Looks really good. I mean, you can see some robot pieces, especially the legs and stuff. But it's a nice, I like the robot. Transformation, real easy. Shouldn't take you that long to figure it out. The paint, really good. I love the head sculpt. I love the mustache. The little goatee looks really nice. I love his eyes, man. I love that ruby red. That looks really good. But yeah, overall, he's got some really, you know, decent paint all throughout. Articulation, really good. He's got an ab crunch. Except mine's a little loosey-goosey, but at least he has an ab crunch. But he has everything else. Toe tilt up, down, and a rocker. I mean, wow. Really great, Hasbro. You did a great job with this fella. So yeah, overall, definitely highly recommend this guy. If you're already in on the 86 movie stuff, you have to get this guy. It's a must-buy. So yeah, there you go. So that's my review. Hope you liked it. Let's kick the baby one more time. All right. And yeah, hit me up some likes, shares, prayers, and care bears. Go ahead and hit that sub button for me. Almost at 6,000. I need some help, y'all, if you don't mind. Hit me up some comments. Tell me you thought of the review. How many people are getting this? I know a lot of people are. They have to. It's Wreck-Gar. Come on now. And I guess I'll see you in the next Transform review. And as always, be good to yourself. Hell, Hasbro. And good night, folks. Man, look at that. I speak TV. I don't know how to do that stuff, so. But he speaks TV. But yeah, beautiful. Love it, love it, love it. Hell, Hasbro.